Malacanang has vowed full support for Philippine Vice President Leni Robredo as she takes on her new role as co-chair of a government committee against illegal drugs. We now have on the line the Vice President's spokesman, Barry Gutierrez. Barry, thanks for taking our call. Welcome to the program.
Hi, Carmina. I'm glad to be here.
All right. So give us the inside story here. There were a lot of concern going into this decision. A lot of her allies telling her don't accept it for one reason or another. But what happened there? How did she prevail upon all those who expressed concern over her accepting this position?
Well, you know, she didn't really have to prevail over anyone. She's leader of the Liberal Party. She's leader of the opposition. She's vice president of the nation. And when she decided to take this on, setting aside all political considerations and zeroing in on the moral responsibility to take on the task, if there could be an opportunity to save lives, then, you know, people respected that. And I think they understood her explanation yesterday. They understood what went into the decision. And despite some initial disagreement on the part of some supporters, they ultimately respected the courage with which she entered and took on this particular challenge, regardless of the political risk involved.
You know, we watched you during that press conference before the vice president accepted this position, and you were saying that everything seems to be pretty vague as of now. Is there more clarity now as to what kind of role, what's going to be on the agenda?
Well, you know, any vagueness, we're leaving that to the palace to address. Our position remains the same, that if you look at the terms of the memorandum itself, the powers being granted to the vice president are phrased very, very broadly. She's being tasked to lead all government efforts against illegal drugs. And right now, the vice president is going to take that as the mandate. There have been statements coming from the presidential spokesperson where he used such terms as she's being given blanket authority, she will get support for everything she wants to do. And we will hold them to that. She's already starting with the mandate given to her, and she will act pursuant to that mandate. Now, I hear Secretary Panelo saying she needs specific powers defined and so on and so forth. Well, they're the ones who extended the appointment. So we'll wait. We'll wait for them to communicate with us and tell us exactly what the limits are, if there are limits that they now want to impose, contrary to their earlier pronouncement.
So what's the next step here? I mean, if we don't get anything from the Office of the President as to what could be done at this point, what's going to be the first step? I mean, does that prevent you or the Vice President to make your own make her own agenda, set her own agenda, set up her own meetings?
You know, just to be clear, Carmina, we did get something from the Office of the President, which is a memorandum where the Vice President was designated to lead all government efforts in the against illegal drugs. So that's what the Vice President is holding on to. She will proceed with her job anchored on that specific mandate from the President. In the same memorandum, the President issued a directive to all agencies under ICAT to extend to her full support and cooperation. And that's the anchor for her authority in this case.
So what's the first?
She is now proceeding to act. You know, based on that that mandate.
So what's the first target here? Because when you look at the drug problem and when you look at the drug war, there are many facets to it. Number one, that it's not a criminality issue, that it is a health issue. It's a social issue as well. And then you talk about rehabilitation and prevention. So where will she start?
Well, you know, I really can't speak as to, you know, all those other issues because, as you said, this is not a not a small problem. This is a multifaceted issue. But what I can say is that today she already instructed and directed all the heads of the relevant agencies under ICAN to give her a briefing tomorrow, where the first order of business will be to give her a accurate, clear and evidence-based picture of where we are right now. One of the problems we have had over the past 3.5 years insofar as the campaign against illegal drugs is concerned is the simple and basic fact that there seem to be no agreement on basic statistics like how many drug users are there really? The estimates range and depend, or depending on who you are talking to, they can be from 1.5, 1.8 million to 4 million to 7 to 8 million. Mm. So obviously, when tackling a problem, the first thing that needs to be understood very clearly by all the agencies concerned is what is the problem and what is the extent of the problem we are dealing with here. So I think that the first thing she will try to settle is getting a handle on how big the problem is, what the current initiatives that have been taken are, how effective have they been, so that she can determine for herself what needs to be changed, what directions need to be given, and what specific directives need to be implemented.
Mm. Now, it's a massive undertaking. It's a huge role. But what will it entail? Will it call for the vice president to bring her own team into the ICAD?
Well, the thing is, ICAD doesn't really have an existence independent of the agencies which comprise it.
Mm-hmm.
It's an interagency committee. So, you know, the heavy lifting is really done by the respective member agencies. I know the details of whether mm-hmm. they will lend staff support and not will be resolved in the following days. But obviously, I think that's an expectation on the part of the vice president. Again, given the directive of the president that all these agencies should extend to her full support and cooperation. But as of now, while that is being resolved, she is, of course, relying on her own team here at the office of the vice president, drawing in some experts as advisors to help her out in the first few days. But obviously, the preference is to start working as soon as possible, being mainstreamed into the existing agencies already engaged in addressing this problem. But definitely, the vice president will still have her own team. The vice president will obviously set her own direction here. And she has very, very clear priorities, which she identified yesterday.
Now, tell me something, though, Barry. I mean, you know that there have been criticisms hurled against each other prior to the acceptance of this position. Criticisms thrown against the drug war, criticisms against the vice president thrown back. How will this lend now to an environment that would make it conducive for cooperation?
Well, you know, the vice president is used to working in an atmosphere of adversity. It's not just under his administration, but, you know, she's gone through a lot of personal trials in her own life, which is nothing new to her. And, you know, the vice president is also one for fresh starts. Regardless of what was said before, regardless of what ill-advised words were said before, she will take the declarations of some of the agency heads made in the aftermath of her accepting the resignation at their face. They say that they will support her, that, you know, that they are fully behind her, that they want to ensure her success. Then, you know, she will take that as true. She will work with them on that assumption up until the time when it's very clear that that's not the case. But, you know, the vice president is not one to hold grudges. She's not one to play politics. In fact, if there's one thing very clear from her statement yesterday, she was very willing to set aside the political considerations so she could focus on what she felt was the bigger issue, which is, can I have the opportunity to actually help people? Can I actually have the opportunity to save lives if I take this position? And that's really the focus of her work in this particular designation right now.
Well, finally, Attorney Gutierrez, you know, this whole acceptance of this new position isn't happening in a vacuum. I was able to speak with Salvador Panelo, spokesperson of the president, a day before the acceptance, and this is what he told me. I'm paraphrasing him now. He said basically they're handing the vice president a ladder to the presidency. And he likened it to when then Vice President Joseph Estrada was given the position of anti-crime czar, which eventually led him to his presidency. What are your thoughts regarding that?
Well, honestly, Carmina, politics was the furthest thing from the mind of the vice president when she decided to accept this. Secretary Panelo was the one who brought it up. He's the one who seems to be focused really on the political aspects of this situation. So I'll leave that to him. As far as the vice president is concerned, she was very, very clear yesterday. Despite the political risks she was warned about, despite the possible implications on her own political career and her own political viability, she was willing to go through with this because she felt it was the right thing to do. And that's what she's focused on. Remember, this is the vice president is not a professional politician. She came into politics very late, and because of the confluence of a set of very extraordinary circumstances. So at heart, she doesn't think with political considerations in mind. She instead focuses on moral and ethical considerations. And I think that all of us saw that yesterday when she decided to take this on, despite the misgivings expressed by her own closest allies, nonetheless, because in her mind, the imperative was trying to make an effort to save lives. And if she is able to do that, despite the limitations here, then I think she will count that as a success. But that said, I just want to say that I was listening earlier to what was what the quote from my friend John Malaya was saying. Mm-hmm. While we appreciate the suggestions on what the vice president should focus on, we hold on to the mandate given to her that she's going to lead government efforts against illegal drugs, and so she will set her own agenda. And I think that will start when she meets the agency heads tomorrow afternoon in the meeting she called here at the office of the vice president.
All right. Attorney Barry Gutierrez there, spokesperson of Philippine Vice President Leni Robredo. We appreciate you taking our call, Barry. Thanks again.
Anytime, Carmina.